Good morning, students. Today we are going to start with the third part of the last chapter, Indian Politics, Trends and Developments. In part two, we have discussed United Front Government and features of coalition government. So, NDA government banti hai hamare desh mein. 1998 mein midterm elections hote hain and for a period of 13 months, the NDA government ruled over the country under the leadership of Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee. NDA was formed in the year 1998. It was a coalition to contest the general elections. And no party got the majority in this. One coalition was formed named as National Democratic Alliance under the leadership of BJP. BJP led this alliance of NDA and it has many regional parties in it. And Samta Party of George Fernandez, Shiv Sena, Akali Dal, AIDMK. It was a big coalition of regional parties and Atal Bihari Vajpayee, he became the Prime Minister for the second time after the outside support of Telugu Desam Party. TDP ke bahar se samarthan ke karan Atal Bihari Vajpayee dusri baar desh ke Pradhan Mantri ke roop mein shapat lete hain 1998. And when this government collapsed after only 13 months because AIADMK leader Jayalalitha withdrew its support, and due to there is one more story behind this, that Giridhar Gamang, who was an MP from Odisha, due to his one vote, because he voted against the government, the government fell at that time. So with one vote the government fell. Ek vote de karke government gir jandi hai. Te pehla Jayalalitha AIADMK di apna support wapas lendi hai. Ta jadon confidence te voting hundi hai to fir Odisha de ek MP de against de vich vote karan de karke Atal Bihari Vajpayee di government gir jandi hai. This was for the second time that Atal Bihari Vajpayee became the Prime Minister and couldn't complete his full tenure. After that, the entry of few more regional parties, NDA proceeded to win in the next general elections of 1999. In the elections of 1999, NDA won with a comfortable majority. And here I must mention that Atal Bihari Vajpayee, he became the Prime Minister of the nation for the third time, and this time he succeeded in completing his full tenure. For the first time he became the Prime Minister in 1996 when BJP was in the minority government, and he retained on the seat for only 13 days. For the second time he became the Prime Minister of the nation in March 1998, and this government completed only 13 months. And for the third time in October 1999, and after this midterm elections, Atal Bihari Vajpayee, he succeeded to complete his full term for a period of 5 years. So, is tarah Atal Bihari Vajpayee teen baar desh ke pradhan mantri bante hain. Pehli baar 13 dinon ke liye, dusri baar 13 mahino ke liye, aur teesri baar 5 saalon ke liye. So, prior to him, Jawaharlal Nehru, he was also elected in 1962, but he died in 64 without completing his third tenure of prime ministership. Indira Gandhi also, she died in 1984 in her third tenure. And Atal Bihari Vajpayee also, he became the prime minister of the nation 3 times. So National Democratic Alliance ki Democratic Alliance hum NDA 1 kise kehte hain. It is the government formed by NDA from March 1998 to October 1999 for a period of 13 months. Usko NDA 1 kehte hain. And from October 1999 to May 2004, which completed its full term, that is known as NDA 2nd. So what were the major highlights of Vajpayee's government? The first one was Pokhran 2nd nuclear test. It was conducted in May 1998, अमेरिका ने इसके बाद बहुत सारे सैंक्शंस इम्पोज कर दिए थे इंडिया के ऊपर, लेकिन इंडिया ने कभी भी कॉम्प्रोमाइज़ नहीं किया नेशनल सिक्योरिटी और नेशनल इंटरेस्ट के मामले में. दिस गवर्नमेंट ऑफ एनडीए ऑल्सो ट्राइड टू इम्प्रूव द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन पाकिस्तान. लाहौर बस सर्विस वॉज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड. कश्मीर इशूज वॉज ट्राइड टू बी रिजॉल्व. इफ द इशू वॉज नॉट रिजॉल्व देन द chances were there then the government tried to improve the relations between the two countries. Artist exchange programs were done, multiple level dialogue talks were there, and as explained earlier that Lahore bus service was also introduced. So at that time Nawaz Sharif was the PM of the nation, and during these dialogues after that just after these dialogues and Lahore bus service and cultural exchange program, Kargil war started between India and Pakistan in 1999. And Indian leaders, they started saying that ki hame to dosti humne to dosti ka haath badhaya tha lekin hame dhoka diya gaya hai. In spite of all this, India won the war and India was successful in capturing all the territories that were gone under the control of Pakistan. One of the major highlight of NDA government was terrorist attack on Indian Parliament on December 31, 2001, because of which the government was criticized at every level. Videos of these attacks you can easily find on YouTube and Google. And moreover, there was a shift in the foreign policy of India. Atal Bihari Vajpayee, he remained on the portfolio of foreign ministry. He was the foreign minister of Janata Party government in 1977. So under his leadership, when he became the prime minister of the nation, he tried to make the ties better with all other countries. Between India and USA, relations were changed, as you have done in the relations of India's foreign policy. And India and Israel relations, they also opened up with a new era. And India-China relations were improved because many agreements were signed on the border. One of the black mark on this government of NDA was Godhra violence of 2002. What happened in Godhra, that some of the car sevaks, they were returning from Ayodhya. A bogie of train in which they were traveling, that bogie were, three bogies were set on fire, and due to that 57 people died in that fire. And it was suspected that some Muslims are responsible for setting the fire. That's why large-scale violence against Muslim community began in Gujarat and some other parts of the country also. This violence continued for almost a whole of the month, and nearly 1100 people, mostly Muslims, they were killed in this violence. So in elaborate way in your book it has been given. You must read it, Godhra Kand, it is there. Godhra mein, Gujarat, Ahmedabad aur Godhra mein violence was spread. Communal riots, you can say, they spread, and due to that the government was criticized at every level. So after that, the next is United Progressive Alliance. It is that UPA is that alliance that is under the, that was led by Congress Party. In 2004, the Congress Party entered in coalitions with Big Way. NDA was defeated and a new coalition government was formed under the leadership of Manmohan Singh, and who received support from left front parties. In the elections of 2004, you can see the revival of Congress, and it was for the first time since 1991 that there was a slight raise in the number of seats scored by Congress Party. And the candidate for Prime Minister was Dr. Manmohan Singh. He was the same Prime Minister, he was a famous economist, and the same Finance Minister in the Ministry of P.V. Narasimha Rao government. in UPA. And the economic reforms that were done, liberalization, privatization, and globalization under the leadership of P.V. Narasimha Rao, these economic reforms, their credit goes to him in initializing this LPG reforms in India. At that time, economy was at a very low pace. So to upgrade the Indian economy, all the credit goes to this man who became the Prime Minister of the nation in 2004. So in again, this was the first tenure of UPA. It is known as UPA 1, United Progressive Alliance ki first. And in the next general elections also in 2009, UPA won 262 seats, out of which Indian National Congress scored 206 seats, and again Mr. Manmohan Singh became the Prime Minister of the nation. So what were the main highlights of UPA 1 and 2 government? The first one is special economic zones. These are those zones which are set up for the industrial units. Some facilities are given to industrial units so that they can be boosted up, they can upgrade, and they can do some improvement in their protection. NREGA was introduced in 2005. MNREGA means Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. Under that, rural employment is given to the people living in the rural area. Right to Information Act, also RTI, also came into force in 2005. It was a major development and a revolutionary step in Indian politics, and many RTI activists, they are still working on this RTI Act. They wanted to expose the wrong policies of the government. Whatever the government want to hide off from common people, they expose all that in front of the people. Jo government chhipana chahti hai, wo sab kuch logon ke samne yahi government leke aati hai. RTI workers leke aate hain. VAT was also introduced, value-added tax. And on 26th November 2008, terrorist attack on Mumbai was done on Taj Hotel of Mumbai, on Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminals, the station of Mumbai, in which the main terrorist was Azmal Kasab. He was arrested, he was caught, and afterwards he was hanged. About this, you can see many videos on Google, on YouTube. You can search for that and you can collect information about that. The Aadhaar card was launched in 2009 only. Anna Hazare movement of 2012, that is compared with JP Jayaprakash Narayan movement against corruption, that was also launched in UPA government only. And this government was a government of various scams. Scams, I want to say that cash for votes, Satyam scam, 2G spectrum scam, CWG scam, and many, many more. Because of that only, in 2004, this UPA lost the elections, and afterwards, NDA again came into power under the leadership of Narendra Modi. That we will do in the next video. So this was all with the NDA 1-2 and its policies and programs, UPA 1-2 and the major highlights of their government. Thank you. Have a nice day.